Hi, I'm Susanna Pollack, president of Games for Change, and I'm very happy to be presenting to you a session today with our delegation partners, COCA. This is the Korea Creative Content Agency, a promotional agency under the Korean government that provides a platform catering to the content industry. Korea has a healthy serious games industry that is mostly led by support from the government, but their industry is gradually transitioning to the public sector, something that I think we can relate to here in the United States. We have 5 game developers all working on different projects across health and learning that are going to present today. This session is going to be focused on health games. And I'm very excited to be introducing 2 developers who have been actively working in this space. Our first speaker is Nuria Freitas, the Chief Marketing Officer of Dev Unlimited. She's going to talk today about Choom Choom, their game, and their overall approach to gamifying dance and exercise.
Hi, my name is Nuria and I'm from Dev Unlimited. Today I want to talk about things that are difficult. So in life, there are things that are really difficult to do. And I'm not talking only about math level difficult or science level difficult. You know, there are things that you really want to do, in fact, but they are difficult to actually do it. So let's say, for example, that you, like me, want to become a dancer, a worldwide famous dancer. In order to do so, you will probably need to take some hours to practice and to choose a location to film it and fail a few times in front of camera. And all of this to film a video and upload it and maybe get a little close to the dream. So here we have a goal that we are passionate about, but some steps in between that we might not actually be so fond of. So if we see this type of problem, what we have here is a life problem inside a game structure. So we have a clear goal, we have a starting point, and we have some tasks and obstacles that prevent us to get to our goal easily. So most of all, the discipline-demanding tasks can fit this type of game structure. And we took a detailed look into one of the most famous problems. See this graph? This graph is the popularity of the keyword workout. And this game is probably the life game that everyone has tried at least once. But not so many people got over the first level. So our quest was, how can we take more people to the final level consistently? So a lot of people thought about this problem. We are not the first ones to do it. In fact, when I was younger, my mom used to say, leave your shoes next to the door before you go out, or prepare the workout clothes on the day before. Some also say that you always have to take a friend to you in order to be sure that you're actually going, or choose a gym that it's close to your home. Still, about 70% of gym subscriptions get out in the first few weeks. So for us, what we thought was, well, when you play a game, you don't leave the remote controller inside of your, like over your sofa in order to start playing the game. Nor you need to call a friend to your home in order to start watching your Netflix series. So we thought that sometimes just fun things drive us. We want to do something just because it's fun. So our mission was find a ways to bring fun to exercise activities. So we thought about different stages of this process. So first stage one will be the fun of exploring. You know, when you have a new game, what leads you to try this game, that game? Or a new series, what leads you to watch the new series? Or a new video? To some is an exciting title. 5 steps to become a better dancer immediately. I'll be interested in that. Or to some is like a very creative thumbnail, an image. Or to most is a friend's recommendation. Having your friends saying, oh, look, this game is awesome. You should try it. So we tried our first strategy to bring people into the game was to create this. Now, on the second part, you are in the game. Now you need to play it. And in order to play it constantly, it needs not to be not too easy that you get bored, and not too hard that you will end up not doing it. So what if you could match the difficulty to your levels, and then you get a badge for small rewards in order for you to keep motivated? But if you also keep getting small rewards, then you might feel bored, so you have to get a bigger reward as well. So a country ranking, a friend ranking, a global ranking. We took a point system to your moves in order that we can place you out and compete with the world. And although I said that you don't need to bring a friend over to start some game or series, I do not deny the power of social. So social interaction is really useful on getting us motivated and making us come back again. I do this, you do that. You're doing great. Keep on going. I also did this. So I don't need to have a friend next to me, but I can play with them online. I mean, we're in 2020, right? And we could get very creative when it gets social. But of course, that would mean nothing if we couldn't make it accessible to everyday's life. So we tried our efforts to make it free, to make it censorless, to make it an application that you could just get in and join with everybody and have fun wherever you want to. So with this idea in mind, we made a game called Chum Chum last year, and we've been sharing with the world with a lot of Korean dances. We have about 1K users, and it was a very fun experience. We went to the US, to Japan, to Thailand, and we had the amazing opportunity to show our game and to receive very positive feedback. But right now, our goal got bigger. We are doing a platform that can include all types of exercises where you can play from boxing to dancing to yoga to many more exciting activities. So the reason why I'm bringing you this presentation was not only to brag about our product, but our team also wanted to share with you that we thinking about game solutions for daily life problems might help a lot of people accomplish their dreams. And helping people accomplishing their dreams brings great productivity and great possibilities for the future. So think about that, and let's solve more bigger problems together. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, Nuria, for the presentation. I loved what I'm seeing, and I'm really, really interested in learning more about your company. We're going to ask a couple of questions now so our attendees can better understand what's happening in South Korea and particularly at Dev Unlimited.
Yeah.
So this company has been around for around 5 years, I think, or so. Or tell me when you guys founded and what are the values about Dev Unlimited and why you're making this kind of product?
Okay, so we founded 3 years ago. And since the beginning, as our name shows, we were very focused on self-improvement. So we wanted to create environments that could help people improve themselves and in a way that was effective. And we found out that we are most effective when we enjoy things. So we kind of shifted our first vision, or in a way we complemented our first vision and trying to add the fun element to what we are doing so that we can effectively achieve the results.
That's great. I mean, I think having people passionate about their work is really important, and it seems to show in what I've seen so far. So you threw your efforts into creating an experience about exercise and about dance, which we know is a popular format, right, for getting people exercises. This is a gamified approach. Tell me what's different about Choom Choom than other kind of dancing experiences, online experiences.
Okay, so we tried to make this as a game, but at the same time, a different type of game. We tried to combine details from three main fields. So from the typical fitness app, at the same time as a game and a score and a gamified version of exercise, but we also try to include social media and social interaction. So while you keep maintaining interaction with your friends and with your community and playing to achieve your results, you can hopefully get better, achieve better your results.
It does seem to me that you are tapping into the current trends, right?
Yeah.
And appealing to young people.
Yeah.
And I think it's going to prove to be very effective. I think it was a great, great choice. So here you are at Games for Change, first time participating in our event, in our community.
Yes.
What is it that you hope to achieve, and what are you looking for in terms of relationships with our community?
Okay, so we want to grow this project. As I told on my presentation, we started with Choom Choom, we started with dance, but we want to expand this project to many other fields in one spot. So there's a big range that exercise can reach, and not only dance, but also yoga, boxing, golf. There's a myriad of things that we can do with this. So we are looking for people that would like to help us reach this goal together. So partnerships and investments is something we are working for and looking for. But yes, that's our vision, and that's the way we are going to from forward. Yeah.
That's great. Well, I hope people will come and visit your virtual booth. You'll learn more about Choom Choom and about Dev Unlimited in general. And I'm really excited about what you are doing and the growth that we can see over the coming years. So thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you very much. They are all invited to meet us at our booth at the marketplace. Thank you.
I'd like to welcome next Jungho Choi. Jungho is the co-founder and CEO of Kitten Planet. They are a startup in the digital healthcare space working on a fantastic product called Brush Monster. Brush Monster is acting as a solution for digital preventative care using the benefits of AR.
안녕하세요. 저는 디지털 덴탈 케어 스타트업 Kitten Planet에서 대표를 맡고 있는 최종호입니다. 키튼 플래닛은 2017년 4월에 삼성전자에서 분사해서 설립된 헬스케어 전문 회사입니다. 현재 디지털 헬스케어 시장은 연 41%의 성장을 거듭하고 있으며 한국을 포함하여 미국에서도 큰 업체들이 많이 소개되고 있는 시장입니다. 저희 키튼플래닛은 전 연령에 걸친 디지털 덴탈 케어 산업을 혁신하고자 설립된 회사입니다. 아동기부터 성인, 노년기까지 저희는 데이터 기반의 덴탈 케어 서비스를 제공하고 플랫폼으로서의 역할을 수행할 것입니다. 저희가 처음으로 소개한 브랜드인 브러쉬 몬스터는 어린이 구강관리 서비스 플랫폼으로 증강현실 AR을 사용한 모바일 앱과 모바일 앱과 연동되는 스마트 칫솔, 데이터 기반의 비즈니스 모델, 캐릭터를 활용한 동기부여 기능을 제공하고 있는 혁신적인 제품입니다. 저희는 설립 이후 2017년 10월 양치 앱을 출시한 이후로 줄곧 200개의 플레이스토어 양치 앱 중에 1위를 달리고 있으며 2018년 4월 한국에서 출시한 브러쉬 몬스터 스마트 칫솔은 현재 한국 어린이 전동 칫솔 1위를 달리고 있습니다. 뿐만 아니라 저희는 12개국에 수출을 성공하였으며 2018년 12월에는 보험회사와 같이 건강증진형 어린이 치아보험을 성공적으로 출시한 이력을 가지고 있습니다. 아이들은 왜 양치질을 싫어할까요? 사실 그 이유는 치약이나 칫솔에 있는 것이 아니라 바로 교육 방식에 있다는 것을 저희는 찾았습니다. 기존의 어린이들에게 양치법을 알려주는 교육 방식은 텍스트 위주 또는 비디오를 시청하게 함으로써 간접 체험 방식으로 아이들에게 설명을 하고 있었습니다. 저희는 간접 체험 방식이 아니라 증강현실 기능을 이용해서 아이들이 자신의 얼굴 위에 가이드되는 증강현실 칫솔을 보고 따라할 수 있도록 개발하였습니다. 영상에서 보시는 것처럼 스마트폰이 마법 거울이 돼서 아이들에게 양치법을 알려줍니다. 블루투스와 모션 센서가 탑재된 스마트 칫솔은 아이들의 행동을 인식하고 아이들이 잘 따라하고 있는지 어디를 잘 닦는지도 알 수 있습니다. 이런 식으로 아이들의 얼굴 위에 실시간으로 영상이 아닌 증강현실 기능으로 가이드를 하고 있으며 아이들의 모션을 인식해서 피드백을 주고 있습니다. 컵을 씻고 마무리하는 동작까지 가이드하고 있으며 양치가 끝나면 16개 영역에 대한 덴탈 리포트를 제공하고 셀피를 찍을 수 있으며 아이 스스로 제대로 양치질을 할 수 있도록 가이드하는 것이 브러쉬 몬스터의 핵심 기능입니다. 저희의 기술은 크게 세 가지로 구성되어 있습니다. 현재 특허에 등록된 증강현실 양치 가이드 기능, 그리고 아이들의 양치 동작을 분석할 수 있는 센서 기능, 세 번째는 이렇게 수집된 데이터를 분석해서 병원, 보험과 데이터를 쉐어링하고 활용할 수 있는 데이터 분석 기능입니다. 저희의 비즈니스 모델은 크게 두 개로 구성되어 있으며 B2C적으로는 피지컬 프로덕트를 기반으로 아이들의 구강용품을 구입하고 활용할 수 있는 기능, 그리고 두 번째는 치과와 보험회사 연계하는 B2B 기능을 가지고 있습니다. 저희는 현재 앱뿐만 아니라 어린이 전동 칫솔 측면에서도 한국에서 1위를 달리고 있으며 저희 앱은 200여 개의 양치 앱 중에서 현재 1위를 달리고 있습니다. 자주 사용할 뿐만 아니라 리텐션도 매우 높습니다. 경쟁사와 비교를 해도 예를 들면 오랄비, 필립스, 디즈니, 베이비버스 같은 경쟁사의 앱과 비교를 해도 소비자의 랭킹이나 아니면은 사용률에서 매우 높은 사용률을 기록하고 있습니다. 저희는 세계 유일의 치과와 보험을 연결하는 구강관리 서비스 플랫폼입니다. 저희는 사용자에게 스마트 칫솔과 모바일 어플리케이션, 컨텐츠를 제공하고 그렇게 획득된 데이터를 바탕으로 치과와 연결을 하고 보험사에게 보험금을 절감할 수 있는 효과를 가져오고 있습니다. 저희가 2019년 1월 출시한 세계 최초 어린이 건강증진형 치아보험에 대해서 짧게 설명을 드리겠습니다. 이 건강증진형 치아보험은 아이가 보험에 가입하는 순간 스마트 칫솔을 무료로 아이에게 주게 됩니다. 그러면 아이는 이 스마트 칫솔을 활용을 해서 가정에서 양치 습관을 기를 수 있도록 연습을 하게 되고요. 이렇게 아이들이 양치한 결과에 따라서 매월 리워드를 제공하고 1년 후부터는 보험료를 할인하는 그런 상품입니다. 저희는 모바일 헬스케어 서비스에 특화된 10명의 팀원으로 구성되어 있으며 저를 비롯해 저희 코파운더는 삼성전자에서 의료기기 및 헬스케어 서비스를 전문으로 개발하고 삼성전자로부터 분사 설립된 회사입니다. 저희는 필요한 여러 가지 자문을 서울대 치과병원을 비롯한 여러 기관으로부터 받고 있으며 보험사, 그리고 삼성전자, 그리고 롯데와 긴밀하게 협조를 하고 있습니다. 저희는 2018년 모바일 서비스와 스마트 치수를 출시한 이후에 국내는 물론 세계적으로도 저희의 커버리지를 넓게 확장하고 있으며 2019년 8월에는 미국에서도 저희 모바일 어플리케이션과 서비스와 스마트 치수를 출시하였습니다. 앞으로도 세계를 비롯해서 아이들의 구강관리 그리고 전 연령의 구강관리 서비스 플랫폼으로서의 키튼플랜스 역할을 확대하기 위해서 많은 파트너들을 찾고 있습니다. 네, 감사합니다.
하이 정호, thank you so much for that presentation. I love what you're doing with Kitten Planet. I wish I knew about this when my kids were little, but thank you for bringing it to the world today. I know you talked a little bit about your relationship with Samsung, but it'd be great for, I think, our community to hear a bit more about how it evolved and what you're doing now.
저는 뇌공학 박사를 전공한 후에 그 삼성전자에 입사해서 4년 정도 헬스케어 서비스를 기획하고 개발을 했었습니다. 그 과정에서 삼성전자의 사내벤처 프로그램이 있어서 어린이 스마트 칫솔 프로젝트를 1년 동안 삼성전자 안에서 진행을 하였고 그 결과가 좋아서 삼성전자로부터 투자를 받으면서 회사를 분사 설립하게 되었습니다. 저와 저희 팀원들은 삼성전자에서 개발자로 일하던 코파운더로 구성되어 있습니다.
Great. Congratulations on that. Okay, well, I have a couple more questions I want to learn about your company and the product that you've created with Kitten Planet. All right, so let's start with the core values, about what it is that it drives you and your mission with your teammates and co-founders at Kitten Planet.
Kitten Planet은 예방 중심의 덴탈 케어 서비스 플랫폼 회사입니다. 기존의 치과 치료는 치료 중심으로 되어 있는데 저희는 예방 중심으로 기존의 치과 치료로 고통받는 사람이 없는 세상을 만드는 것으로 저희가 노력하고 있는 회사라고 봐주시면 됩니다.
Great. So what is it you think about Kitten Planet that and the product that is so successful, because you've had a lot of success with it so far. What do you think the differences are, or the advantages from other games that have attempted this in the past?
덴탈 케어 문제를 해결하기 위해서 많은 기업들은 화학적인 방법으로 치약을 개발하고 물리적인 방법으로 칫솔을 개발하고 있지만 저희는 디지털적인 방법으로 세상을 혁신하려고 합니다. 게임은 저희가 사람들에게 디지털적인 변화를 주기 위한 매우 좋은 동기부여 요소라고 생각합니다. 저희가 여러 양치 앱 중에서 1등을 달리고 있는 이유도 증강현실 기반의 게임적인 요소가 저희의 타겟인 어린 아이들에게 흥미를 주고 스스로 제대로 양치할 수 있게 만들었기 때문이라고 차별점을 설명드리고 싶습니다.
So we're seeing that augmented reality designed experiences like yours can have this behavioral change, which is really an incredible thing to see. I'm curious how you're seeing the effects of COVID-19 and people's thoughts about disease and caution are affecting or improving sales for you.
네. 코로나19를 통해서 질환을 예방하고 관리하는 것에 전 세계적으로 관심이 커지고 있습니다. 단순히 마스크를 끼고 손을 씻는 것뿐만 아니라 공기와 음식물이 들어오는 구강 관리에도 관심이 커지고 있습니다. 저희가 서비스하고 있는 브러쉬 몬스터는 아이들의 양치 습관을 향상시키며 궁극적으로는 아이들의 치아후식증을 예방하는 디지털 신약으로서의 역할을 앞으로 할 수 있을 것으로 기대하고 있습니다.
Great. I hope we can as well. So you also be participating in the digital booth, and hopefully our attendees will come and visit, learn more about Kitten Planet and Brush Monster. Is there anything in particular you're looking for in terms of partnerships with our community?
저희는 디지털 트랜스포메이션에 관심이 많은 P&G나 유니레버 같은 생활용품 회사나 신규 환자를 유입하고 치료 후에 관리하는 데 관심이 많은 치과, 그리고 보험 가입자의 건강을 관리하고 증진하여 보험금을 낮추는 데 관심이 있는 보험사, 그리고 모바일 어플리케이션을 이용한 디지털 신약에 관심이 있는 제약사들과 많은 얘기를 G4C에서 하고 싶습니다.
Well, great. Well, I wish you the best of luck. It's a really fun approach to dental hygiene, and parents around the world are going to thank you for that. All right. Thank you so much. And I think we're going to go on to the next one. Thank you so much. Really, really fun. Really fun. And good luck. Well, that wraps up our first session with Coca and fantastic developers from Kitten Planet and Dev Unlimited. I'd like to thank Jung Ho and Nuria for joining us today, and both will be available as part of our virtual marketplace at their respective booths. So I hope you can all check it out and go continue a conversation.